Yeah, that's a great question. I mean, I think that the things that I would use to kind of help start framing that are, are there any guardrails that scripture gives us that helps us frame, when are we starting to move outside and when are we, within the middle? And then also just some perspective things about today, to think about. Before we got online, we were talking about how today a lot of my day was driven by the traffic and how bad that was. And in a sense, that's sort of this technological structuring of my very life, and what I can and can't do, and how much I see my family and work, and all that stuff is structured by things that are well outside of me. And so I think putting some of that kind of perspective on it can be helpful before you just jump in and say, can you put this in your body or not, right? Because I think it would be hard to evaluate, each one and make binary yes or no calls. So I don't think we can say exact yes or no, but I think we can start to put some guardrails on it.
Yeah, one of my favorite quote unquote arguments when people are talking about the overuse of tablets and smartphones, especially with their kids. I mean, no one would ever say, little Johnny, and I just picked that randomly, John, not because you're John.
I've been getting out of for a few years.
It's not like people say to the kids, you're reading too much. You really need to guard the time that your children spend reading books. I mean, no one would ever say that, but yet right. That is a form of technology.
Yeah, exactly. And I think, depending on the generation, you do see that, what the concern is. And so there used to be some concern about people kind of getting too absorbed into the book world, and you don't see that as much anymore. I think if I was going to put like maybe one or two sort of guarding type things on it, I mean, I think for me, when I get to kind of the Genesis 2 area and God looks at the garden and he puts Adam there and he says, what's Adam there for? And the two things he gives him, one is this word cultivate or make or something like that, where it's like God's kind of dumped out a box of Legos and said, make something from this. Your job is to make tools and take all the natural resources to create stuff. That's your job. And then the other one, though, is this word of like keeping or preserving, where, it would be normally with a garden, it would be just upkeep. But there's also this idea of that word can be used for like a soldier to guard a city, So I think like, if God dumps out the Legos, you don't want to just like melt them and burn them, right? So you need to do some element of balancing this making and preserving. And then I think if God is the example of making, then he certainly has this rhythm of work and then of Sabbath. And that Sabbath is there, before the law that Christ abolishes, right? That's something that's built into, the beginning of before their sin and all that stuff. So I think for me, somewhere in between this, this making and preserving, right? I want to be somewhere in there where I'm not just lazy and not working, but I'm also not so much working that I'm changing myself too much. And then I also want to make sure that I have some ability to have some rhythm of work and rest that I can, I don't know if I want to use the word control, but that I can kind of enter into. And when I start losing those things, then I start getting a little bit worried. And for me, one of the fun things about what I think sci-fi does really well is that it helps you kind of think about what humanity actually is today by seeing things shifted just a little bit. But we almost live in a sci-fi world where instead of like them all being these dreams of what it would be like 100 years from now, most things are like, oh, that's what it's going to be like in 5 years, right? And so I think when you think about implantable technology and what if something was always on all the time, would I be able to have a Sabbath? Well, in reality, like I kind of have an implantable chip in my pocket, right? This thing is almost always on me, and I think about it a lot. I'm right now, Angry Birds Transformers is trying to get me to go get some coins, And so in a sense, I have this like this sort of pull, and so as I reflect about what it would be like to have an implantable Apple Watch or whatever. And that seems I kind of have this knee-jerk reaction. I would never want that. But I kind of functionally live that way today. So I think that's what's cool about looking at these future things is that they help you see what you're currently doing today in a better.
Excellent. John, always clear, concise answers. I appreciate your study of technology and being able to present it in such a palatable way that anyone, whether it be, somebody who writes code like you do, or somebody who's just, they just got onto Facebook and they're just trying to navigate this stuff. No matter where you are on the spectrum of technology, you're able to provide, thoughtful, practical answers that as Christians we can really hold on to.
Well, good. Well, man, I appreciate being with you. And just a second, I want to take a picture of you real quick. Hang on. So.